Hello and welcome. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effect. In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about one of the most overlooked ways to get beautiful, natural-looking lens flare in Sapphire LensFlare, using triggers. One of the great things about Sapphire's lens flare is how it can create realistic, natural-looking flares. And one of the big reasons why this can happen is because some of the flare elements move around and change depending on where the hotspot is in our screen. Now, what you may have noticed is when you're in the flare designer creating these flares, we can get a variety of subtle movements that just don't work once we return to our main host. And the reason for this is because of two of the parameters that are some of the most overlooked in the whole of this effect. And these are our triggers, our edge triggers and our center triggers. And these determine brightness and scale of our flares once we move close to the center or towards the edges. And there are two elements to this. First, we have to define what our center and edges are, and then we have to say what we want to happen when it reaches those sides. And that's what these triggers do. So I'm going to turn on my show edge zones for the edge triggers. We'll look at edge triggers first. The center works in the same way. So the first parameter is the edge width. So this is how far into the screen we start counting our edges and how close into the center it is before we start doing stuff to our flare. And it's shown with this black to white ramp. And we can also determine the fall off, so we determine where the range of that black to white is. Now, for these values, I usually find that an edge width of around about 0.2 to 0.3 is perfect. So we'll start with 0.25 here. This gives us quite a nice, smooth, gentle movement in here. And an edge fall off between 2 and 2.5 is also quite good. We'll stick with the default of 2 here for now. With edges, we also have this shift out parameter. And if I take this in a negative way, this lets us move where our edge is. I can be affecting the flare not quite at the edge, so I can move our edge in somewhere. But usually this is used in a positive way to then push our edge out a little bit, so that when we go off screen, we get this extra sort of flash of flare, even when our flare goes quite far off screen there. Let's just undo that a couple of times. Brings back to where we were. And before I reset my shift out, I just want to show you what this one way does. If I turn this on here, it means we don't get a separate fall off for our edge. Once we reach pure white, it stays that way. I usually find that turning this off gives a much more natural look to the flare. Okay, so let's just reset our shift out again to 0 so that it's now going around the edge one more time. And I'll turn the edge zones off. So now we've determined where the edge is, we actually need to come in and decide what's going to happen to our flare. And that's what we do with the edge scale brightness and the edge scale widths. So if I bring this up really quite far, I'll set this to 3, and the edge scale width, so I'll set that all the way up to 2. What's going to happen now is that as we get closer to white on the edge scales, our brightness and our widths of the flare elements are going to be scaled up in this way here. Now, this is quite an extreme effect, maybe too extreme. Say maybe, it's absolutely too extreme for what I want to show. Let's just stop manipulating the hotspot there and just reset that to the defaults of 1.5 and 1.2. And you can see this is a much more subtle change. And the nice thing about this is that we can change this up. Maybe I will take my scale widths to 2 and we get a more extreme effect depending on what you want. So let's take a look at what that does to our clip here. This is the flare where we don't have our edge set up correctly. So I'm going to come into my effects, go down to my edge triggers, and I have my edge width set to 0.25. Let's set that to 0.2. and I have my edge brightness set to 1 and my edge scale width set to 1 as well. So that means that these aren't going to be multiplied by any more than their original values. So let's change this and I'll set my edge widths to, what should we say, 1.75. And I'll scale my brightness up very, very small amount. Let's set this to 1.25. And in fact, maybe I'll make this a little bit more extreme so we can see this a bit better. So I'm going to set my edge widths to 2.25. There we go. So that is now very, very visible. Now, if I move to this other flare, we look at the edge triggers here. Even if I scale up something like the widths and the brightness, not all of the elements are being affected. So if we have a look at this ring around here, that's not being affected by my widths changed at all. And the simple reason for this is that these are multipliers. These triggers are multipliers, but they're multipliers of what? Well, let's pop into the flare designer and see exactly what's going on here. So if I come to my red ring and we look down at the animation, we can see the brightness response on the this particular ring is set to 0 and width response is set to 0 as well, which means that this particular element, this one here, won't react at all to any of our triggers. If I change this to a different flare now, one that we can see is actually responding to our triggers. Let's have a little look at the rings. There we go. And I'll just take a look at the solid of the selection again. Let's find a nice ring there. There you go, this magenta ring here. And we take a look at the animation on this one. We can see that the brightness response here is set to -1.78 and the width response is set to 1.62. So this is the movement that gets multiplied by the triggers back in the host. And if we look down at the center trigger works in the same way. We set up the center zone in the same way. Probably keep this between 0.15 and 0.2. We have the same fall off, and then we can also control the brightness and the widths, so the multipliers, when our flare goes over the top. And this is how we can start to get our flares dancing across the screen, by setting up our edge triggers and our center triggers correctly. Thanks for watching. To learn more about Sapphire LensFlare and all the other effects that are available in the Sapphire collection, visit us at borisfx.com, where you'll also be able to find the latest product news, tutorials, and download a free trial. Thanks for now, and I'll see you again soon.